Now we continue with exercise 5.2. Question number 4. The adjoining pie chart gives the marks scored in an examination by a student in Hindi, English, Mathematics, Social Science and Science. If the total marks obtained by the students were 540, answer the following questions. In which subject did the student score 105 marks? Now the pie chart shows the marks scored in an examination by a student in a different subjects, and the total marks obtained by the student were 540, the total marks. Now you have to find out, first question, in which subject did the student score 105 marks? Now here the central angle is given, central angle corresponds to each subject is given, the marks is not given, but the total mark is given. What is the total mark? 540. Now look at that, how we can find out the marks, that means in which subject he scored 105 marks, that is the question. In which subject he scored 105 marks. Then the total angle at the center of the circle is 360 degree, and which corresponds to the total marks. So what is the total marks? 540 marks. So 540 marks, the central angle is 360 degree. Central angle is equal to 360 degree. The central angle is 360 degree. Therefore, for one mark, what will be the central angle? For one mark, the central angle is equal to 360 divided by 540. So for one mark, the central angle is 360 degree. Therefore, for one mark, the central angle is 360 by 540. Therefore, for 105 marks, the central angle is equal to 360 divided by 540 into 105. Now we have to simplify. Using 3, we can cancel 105 and 540. 1 time, then 8, 0, 180, 35. Then 180 and 360 we can cancel with 180, 1 time, then 2 times. So 2 into 35, which is equal to 70. So the central angle is 70 degree. Now look at the pie chart. The central angle is 70 degree for which subject? Hindi. So for Hindi, so he got 105 marks in a Hindi. So in Hindi he got 105 marks. So in which subject did the student score 105 marks? So he scored 105 marks in a Hindi. Now second question. How many more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi? How many more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi? Mathematics, look at that, the central angle is 90 degree. Hindi, the central angle is 70 degree. Which one is greater? 90 degrees greater. So mathematics, he got more marks than Hindi. Therefore, how many more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi? So in mathematics, how much, that means we want to find out the marks in mathematics. So how we can find out the marks in mathematics? Second question. Let x be the marks in maths or mathematics. Let x be the mark in mathematics. Then out of 540, he got x marks in a maths. Then how can you find out the corresponding central angle? Suppose he got x marks in maths, How can he find out the central angle? The total mark is 540. Out of 540, he got x. Then how can he find out the central angle? Into 360. And the central angle for the subject match is given, what is that? 90. So we can write it as x by 540 into 360 degree equal to 90 degree. Therefore, 360 into x by 540 equal to 90. Now we can do the cross multiplication. Then 360 into x, 360 x is equal to 90 into 540. Therefore, x is equal to 90 into 540 divided by 360. Now 90 and 360 we can cancel with the 90. So 90 one time, 90 into 4, 360, 4 times. Then we have to find out what is 540 divided by 4. One time 4, 3 times 12, then 25. So 135. So he scored 135 marks in maths, and Hindi he got how much? 105 marks. So how many more marks were obtained by the student in mathematics than in Hindi? How many more marks? That is 135 minus 105 equal to 135 minus 105, so 30. He got 30 marks, 30 more marks in maths than in Hindi. Then third part of the question. Examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. Examine whether the sum of the marks obtained by obtained in a social science and maths. Examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in social science and in mathematics is more than in a science and Hindi. So you have to study, just to study the central angles. So you have to look into the central angles. Therefore, sum of the central angles in social science and maths. Social science, what is the central angle? 65. Science, what is the central angle? Social science and maths. Social science 65 degree, maths 90 degree. So sum of the central angles in social science and maths. Third part, sum of the central angles. Social science and maths. So we have to find out the sum of the central angles in social science and maths. So which is equal to 65 degree plus 90 degree. Which is equal to 155 degree. Similarly, sum of the central angles in science and Hindi. Science how much? 80. Hindi 70. Science and Hindi. Sum of the central angles. Central angles in science and Hindi. Sum of the central angles in science and Hindi. So science and Hindi, it is 80 degree and 70 degree. So what is that? 80 plus 70, 150 degree. Now you have to look at the. So examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in social science and maths is more than in science and Hindi. So you have to look into the central angles. Sum of the central angles is greater in which one? In science, social science and maths. So sum of the central angles in social science and maths is 155 degree, and sum of the central angles in science and Hindi is 150 degree. Which one is greater? 155 degree is greater. So the marks will be, sum of the marks in science and maths will be more than sum of the marks in science and Hindi. So what we can write out the answer? Yes. Yes. So examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. Yes. The sum of the marks obtained in social science and maths is more than that in science and Hindi. So you have to look into the central angles, find out the sum of the central angles, no need to find out the marks. Now next question, the number of students in a hostel speaking different languages is given below, display the data in a pie chart. So one more pie chart is given, so we have to draw the pie chart. Now we can make a table. First column we can write language, then second column number of students, then language Hindi 40, then English 12, then Marathi 9, Tamil 7, Bengali 4, and here the total is already given and the total is equal to 72. Now we have to find out the central angle, right? Now to draw the pie chart, we have to find out the central angle. Then a central angle, so we want to find out the proportion of each sector, proportional value of the proportion of each sector we have to find out. And how to find out the proportion of each sector? Out of 72 it is a 40, so 40 by 72, this one will be the proportion of each sector. Proportion of each sector, we are not writing it in a separately, okay? So we are combining, so we need only the one column, that is a central angle. Central angle, first we have to find out the proportion of each sector, then find out the corresponding angle, that is into 360, and you will get the central angle of the sector. So this fraction will represent the proportion of the sector, that means the sector which corresponds to Hindi, that you will get it. So which is equal to, then 72 and 360, how many times 72 will go in 360? Then 360 divided by 72, that is the easiest way. So 5 times, 2 5s are 10, okay, 360. So 72 and 360 we can cancel with the 72 itself, with the 72, then one time, here it is 5 times. So 40 into 5, you will get 200. So 200, first one is 200. Then a second one, so the proportion of each sector, so corresponds to the sector, that means for the English, the proportion will be 12 by 72, that is the proportion or in fraction. In the textbook it is given two separate columns, one is given as in fraction, that means we are they are finding out this value separately, and here we combined it. So 12 by 72 into, then the corresponding angle, that is into 360, then 72 and 360 we can cancel, then with the 72 5 times, so you will get 60 degree. Next 9 by 72 into 360, 5 times, so 9 5 is 45, so 45 degree. Next is 7, 7 by 72 into 360 degree, so 72 and 360 we can cancel with the 72, 5, 7 5 is 35. Then the last one is a 4, 4 by 72 into 360. Then 72 and 360 we can cancel with the 5, which is equal to 20, so 20 degree. So when we add whether we are getting 360, look at that, 5 plus 5, 10, carry over 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 4, 10, 60, then 360. So the central angles, the central angles for each sector, that is correct. Okay. Now these fractions we can call it as the proportion of each sector, then you find out the corresponding angle, then you will get the central angle of the sector. Now we have to draw the pie chart. First you have to draw a circle. Draw the circle. Then look at the value of the central angles. First one is what? 200 degree. Okay. So this 200, first what you have to do is the smaller angles you have to mark it. First you have to mark the smaller angles you have to represent. Then the remaining lastly you will get 200 degree. Otherwise it will be difficult for in order to mark the angle 200 degree. Therefore, first of all we will start from a 60 degree onwards. First we will mark 60 degree. First 60, then a 45, 35, 20. 60 degree, 45 degree, 35 degree and 20 degree. Then mark the center of the circle. Then draw a line, that means the radius of the circle first to draw. Then take a protractor, keep the protractor at the center, okay, center of the circle. Then the first angle is 60 degree, then 60 degree will come here. Mark 60 degree. Okay, so 60 degree. Now take this line as the baseline. Okay, keep the center of the protractor like this. Then a 0 will coincide with the line. Therefore, the next angle is a 45. 45 will come here. Then next is a 35, keep the protractor, then the 0 will coincide, 35, 35 degree. Then next is, so you have to keep the protractor in this way. So this line you have to take it as the baseline. Then keep the protractor and it is 20. Now look at that. So the remaining angles. So look at that, this remaining angle. So this one you can take it as how much? 200 degree. It will be equal to 200 degree. So first of all, you have to mark this smaller angles. That is easy for you. Then the lastly, you will get the remaining angle that will be equal to 200 degree. So look at that. When you keep the protractor like this, when you keep a straight line like this, you will get 180 degree, and the remaining we have a small part that will be 20 degree, and it is equal to how much? 200 degree. So that's all for today's class. Thank you.